for breakfast. Frosties for a quick sugar buzz, or all bran for a good clear out.
Neither. Garthy made me breakfast in bed. Deviled kidneys.
Lovely.
I'm really worried about him, Shell. He's got to be up to something.
Oh, I was listening to that. Up to what?
I don't know. He's just being too nice. I don't even get this sort of treatment on Mother's Day.
What's the matter with you? Most kids his age are out nicking cars or getting rat-arsed every night. You should be really pleased he makes a fuss of you. No one else does.
It's just a bit sudden, that's all. And turn that crap off. What's the matter with Radio 1?
Besides the fact that it churns out remorseless techno-pop for people with no discernible brain cells, nothing.
That's good. From the woman who once said her number one desert island disc was Una Paloma Blanca.
Not because I like it. It just brings back fond memories of the time Chris was dancing to it at that disco in Margate. Tripped himself up, spilt his lager over two rugby players and spent a week in traction. But I've changed, Trace. I want to broaden my horizons. I want to learn more about proper music and culture and things.
Oh, of course, because you don't want to make a gonk of yourself in front of Colin again. Honestly, Shell, even I know the Nutcracker Suite's a ballet and not a sofa and two armchairs.
I was mucking about.
Oh, yeah.
Look, there's nothing wrong with wanting to improve yourself. I've met a bloke whose cultural horizons go beyond the Sunday sport. I want to keep up with him.
So what cultural treat has he got lined up for you tonight?
We're going to the King's Head.
What, having a quiz night, are they? Can I come?
It's a fringe theatre, actually. There's a new play by Kevan Bromwich. Or was it Albion?
Kevan Bromwich?
Oh, did I hear you say Kevan Bromwich? How exciting!
Have you heard of him?
Her, actually. She's a promising New Zealand dramatist whom critics are acclaiming as the Antipodean Timberlake Wurtenbaker.
Never mind.
How do you know?
She was on Radio 4 starting the week with Melvin Bragg.
Lucky cow.
Can I smell a full English breakfast?
Tracy's just had it in bed.
With whom?
On my own. You're a trollop, you are.
Speaking of trollop, Sharon, I brought you the Barchester Chronicles and, Mahler's Fourth, the easy-listening symphony for the uninitiated. And don't get egg yolk all over the books, please. Now, you were saying, Tracy.
I was saying, you might not mind having your bacon and eggs with some strange bloke.
Over easy.
But the only bloke who's getting in between my sheets is my Daryl.
So I really admire you, Tracy. How long is it now?
She can't remember. It's been 3 years since she's seen it.
I don't understand about being faithful, Dor. Can you imagine having to spend the rest of your life with one man?
Well, actually, that's just what I have been imagining because I am thinking of falling in love.
Leave it out.
Who is the poor sod, then?
His name is Emile. He's French and he is to die for. Looks like Gérard Depardieu. Soulful eyes, shaggy mane, big nose.
What's so great about a big conk, then?
What they say, big nose.
Big handkerchief.
So where did you find this frog then?
He's moved into the Weeping Willows, you know, the house across the road, with the home-based carriage lamps and the manual garage doors.
Well, and there's no Mrs. Emile about.
No woman at all, but he is as yet resistant to my wiles. Now, I have been over there several times, masquerading as the neighbourhood watch coordinator, but he keeps giving me short shrift.
It's not like you to get anything short from a bloke, doll.
Still, maybe his short shrift sort of balances out his big conk.
Cheers. Thank you. The thing I don't understand is...
Yeah?
Why is Celia keeping this Ukrainian locked up in a spare bedroom? And why is Vladimir submitting to this ordeal when she won't even let him touch her? Even though they both start naked. I mean, if I was to get a bloke star, because there'd be no stopping me, he wouldn't know what to do.
She won't let him touch her because she feels that way she's not being unfaithful to her husband. But I think we ought to wait for the second act to reveal the play's imagistic methods and its symbolic potential.
I love it when you talk all clever. You know who you remind me of?
Kenneth Branagh?
Inspector Morse. I bet you love opera and you go round solving lots of crimes with a bloke called Lewis.
The only thing I've got in common with Morse is we both like beer. And besides, he never seems to get off with a bird.
Well, you've no worries there.
Now, can I ask you something?
anything.
This is not easy for me.
Oh, God, here we go. You don't want to see me again. Whenever a bloke says this isn't easy for me, it's followed by, Sharon, I really like you, but I think we ought to stop seeing each other. Or, Sharon, I really like you, but I think I'd better get dressed. My wife's expecting me home for dinner.
Sharon, cool it. I do want to see you, OK? No, what I want to ask you is, can we use your house?
What? Of course we can. Comes and realises I've got my own life to lead. As long as you don't make me make too much noise.
No. When I say we, I don't mean you and me. I mean we, the Met.
Eh?
Well, it's like this. One of my governors, Detective Inspector Dunford, wants to do a round-the-clock surveillance of somebody in Brian Close. Now, don't ask me who, because I haven't got a clue. And as he knows that we go out together, he had me up in his office this morning asking me to ask you if it wouldn't be too much of an inconvenience to set up in your house.
You are joking. Tracy wouldn't have police in Dallin Trace.
She's always been really nice to me.
She likes you. She considers you an honorary human being. Oh, I'm sorry, Cole. You'll have to tell him no.
Well, that's a bit of a worry. Because he also added if it was too much of an inconvenience, that you could have the local Nick hassle you and your sister, and that would be an even worse inconvenience. Now, I said to him, I don't want to get involved. And he said, you're involved with a villain's old lady. Now, if you don't want that spread about...
A toe rag.
I'm sorry, Shell.
It'll be all right. I'll break it gently to Tracy.
Are you heir to your tree? I suppose he got your rat arse before he asked ya.
Look, Trace.
No, you look, Sharon. I don't believe you sometimes. You've done a lot of bloody stupid things in your time, but saying yes to having the old Bill in my ass, under my roof, I'm lost for words.
No, you're not. You're doing just great.
And to make things worse, it's a detective inspector. You may have forgotten it was only a detective inspector that put our husbands away.
Did me a favour.
I'm expected to entertain this copper, be nice and civil to him, feed him.
Look, I don't want your whole house, Trace, just one room. Oh, go on, Trace, please, for Colin. Or Dunford would make his life a misery.
Look, I'm sorry, Shell, but it's not my problem.
Look, I only said yes because they're after a big villain. I'm not sure, but Colin did imply it could be an international drugs dealer.
Drugs? Huh? Are you sure?
Yeah. Could be that French bloke across the road what Dorian fancies. We don't know nothing about him, do we? He could be the French connection.
Drugs? That's different. If there's one thing I hate more than coppers, it's drug dealers. And this is a respectable neighbourhood. We've got a Conservative MP, for God's sake. I mean, Edmonton, yes. Drugs were rife where you used to live. I once got offered some coke in the lift of your old block. Gave the kid a good smack.
Kid must have loved you. Smack was expensive round Edmonton.
Don't say nothing in front of Garthy.
Hi, Mum. Pardon you, Shell.
Blimey, Garth, where you been? You smell like the inside of a beer barrel.
To a stag night. Richard on my course is only getting married tomorrow, isn't he? And he had this stag over in Epping Forest. He had strippers, enough booze to sink the Ark Royal, and a diagram.
A diagram of what?
No, a princess diagram. Yeah, this really tasty blonde suddenly comes in, dressed up as a Princess of Wales, does a quick speech about safe sex, strips off, then unrolls this big giant condom over Richard's head. Poor sod is nearly suffocated.
They'll burst when you don't want them to.
Nice one, aren't you, Sharon?
But no drugs.
What?
I said, but no drugs.
Mum, no, there were no drugs. And even if there were, Bin, I'd have had nothing to do with them. The only thing I've ever had up my nose is Vic's Sinex. Okay?
Okay.
Night, Auntie Shell. Night, Mum.
Night, girl.
Good night.
You're a lucky girl, Trace. He don't bat for the other side. He don't get involved with gold diggers and he don't talk to trees. What would the Queen give to have a son like him?
Madam, sorry we're a little late.
I ain't ordered nothing. What's going on? Oh, right, you're the filth.
Detective Inspector Greg Dunford. This is my colleague, Constable Stephanie Wheatley. Do you want to see our warrant cards?
No, it's all right. But what's with all this fancy dress and all this gear and all?
Well, you never know who might be snooping around. I hear you have some very nosy neighbours.
One I can think of.
Yeah, well, if she did happen to be peeping through her curtains, all she'd see is John Lewis delivering a new dishwasher. But enough small talk. We'll need a bedroom that faces front with ensuite facilities.
I suppose you'll want a double bed and all.
This is important. I'll take two sugars in my tea.
Anything else?
Well, obviously, we'll need regular meals. And Constable Wheatley is a vegan.
Sorry I asked. Bloody vegans don't eat nothing.
Oh, what a crappy day. Why is there a dishwasher box in the hall?
They're here.
Who's here? Oh, the police.
And they came in disguise.
There's a dishwasher. Not doing their tea, are you?
I ain't got no choice, have I? They're not allowed to leave the room for a week, and one of them's a vegan.
Got pointy ears, has he? Right, I'm going for a shower.
Why, you don't smell that bad?
I'm going out with Colin tonight, all right.
All right, you can use my shower.
Why should I? Got my own one.
No, you ain't.
Eh?
Well, they're in your room, aren't they?
What? Why?
Because they needed a room that faced the right direction for spying.
Well, yours faces the same way.
I ain't having them in my room. I didn't invite them round here.
All right, forget the shower. Where am I supposed to sleep?
In the attic room.
I'm scared of heights.
Well, in the box room.
I'm scared of boxes. Come on, Trace, I want my room. With my teddy bear collection in it. With my bed. The room with my clothes in my wardrobe. And my share that if you don't know how to fiddle with just right, you get scolded. See?
And I'm not collecting for Jewish charities. What do you think I was doing? Good thing I'm wearing all my rings, or who knows what injuries I could have sustained. Why was the door locked? How am I supposed to get in if the door's locked?
You've got the rules all wrong, Dor. Me and Tracy live in this house, so we come and go through this door. You live next door, so you come and go through the door that came with your house. It's easy once you've got the hang of it. Tracy'll have a fit. You know how stroppy she can get after a difficult visit.
What's so special about today's visit?
Nothing. Just might be a tough one, that's all.
Is it because of something important she has to tell Darryl, or something important she isn't going to tell Darryl?
What are you on about, Dor?
Sharon, please. Don't treat me like a cretin. Not much gets past me.
Certainly not if it's got a hairy chest.
Last night, as I was coming home from a liaison dangereux, I saw her in the window with a man.
It was me and Colin.
No, it wasn't. The woman went in at the waist. I know who it was, Sharon.
Okay, Dor, you got me. There's two detectives upstairs from the Serious Strumpet Squad keeping an eye on you, okay?
Very funny. Right, now I'll tell you what I think, shall I? Tracy isn't as innocent as she appears, is she? She was up there with a man, wasn't she?
I think you better sit down, Dor. I'm going to tell you something in complete confidence. If I find out that you've told a soul, I'll murder you. No, worse than that, I'll flambé your credit cards.
My word, this must be momentous.
Momentous is an understatement. Now, I want it to go no further than these four walls, all right? Cross your heart.
I don't cross my heart, I'm Jewish.
What do you cross?
My checks. I'll keep them, I promise.
Tracy has a secret lover.
Well, that much I had worked out for myself.
But this is no ordinary secret lover. More a sex puppet. Their relationship is so fantastic, it makes even your sex life look mundane.
Impossible.
Oh, but there's so much you don't know about Tracy. So many deep, dark secrets.
Well, go on.
He's a young Ukrainian sailor who jumped ship at Tilbury. He hitched a ride with her. Something magical happened on the A13, and he's been up there ever since. She's told him he's free to go, but he wants to be her sex slave.
The A13, you say?
And so, every night, Tracy lets him out of the attic and into her room for just 1 hour. He takes off all his clothes. She takes off all her clothes. But she won't let him touch her. That way she figures she's still being faithful to her Daryl. Oh, I think I've said enough.
Enough? You can't stop now. Come on, more. People pay good money to hear stories half as good as these on the 0898, but not me, I might add. This is a joke, isn't it? My God. Is he up there now? Naked.
Probably oiling his torso even as we speak.
Back, Shell. Didn't tell Daryl, and now I feel really deceitful. Is he still up there? Oh, no, we ended a burglary, have we?
No, I'm afraid it was me. I was trying to get in and accidentally put a 3-carat baguette through it.
You should watch what you're doing with your French salad sandwiches. I hope you're paying to have it fixed.
Naturally. Is who still up there, Tracy?
I? Oh, Garfy. He was out on the drink till the small hours. Couldn't get him out of bed this morning. He had an important lecture too. 10 things to do with Jerusalem artichokes.
Still, never mind. Dorian can fill him in on 8 of them.
Makes a cup of tea, shall?
No, I only ask who was upstairs, Tracy, because last night I saw silhouetted on your bedroom blind a man and a woman, a slim woman.
Saucy little sod. No wonder he was knackered. He weren't on the drink, he was on the job. Told you before about smuggling his birds back here.
No, it can't have been Garth, because at 11:30 last night, your son was leaving Emile's house. I saw him. But I also saw 2 people in the window. I know who it was, Tracy. Sharon has told me.
What, Garth was coming out of the Frog's house?
Yes. They came out together, shook hands, and then Emile gave Garth an envelope. Didn't see what it was. Does he speak any English, or are you learning Ukrainian?
Break his neck, the two-faced little dopehead. You know what he was doing, didn't you? Getting dope from him over there.
What? Oh, don't be silly. Emile's not a drug dealer.
I told you he was being too nice. Breakfast in bed, flowers. He wouldn't know Interflora from Inter Milan. My Garth's on drugs, which he's been getting from over there, and they've affected his brain too. I'm going to go and turn his room over and find out what he's been taking before the police do. I've got one of my men in prison. I don't want 2.
Though perhaps you might get some kind of discount from British Rail. It was a light-hearted quip. What's going on?
Dorian, you cow! You promised what I told you won't go beyond these 4 walls.
Well, it hasn't, has it?
He's found 50 quid in his pocket. Where did he get 50 quid from?
Probably selling his body on the streets.
What?
Well, it's about as likely as him being on drugs, isn't it?
Well, of course he ain't on drugs. He wouldn't have any money if he was on drugs, would he? No, it's worse. He ain't buying, he's selling. Old French Connection features has turned my Garth into a drug dealer.
So he's a villain. He's only following in his father's footsteps.
I think I'll go. My psychodrama's on a Friday. you sure the words Ukrainian oiled torso and A13 mean nothing to you?
Look, I'm really, really sorry, Shell. I don't know what came over me, I swear. You pushed me over the edge.
You're always hitting me.
I'm not. I never hit you.
What about that time at school?
That was 20 years ago. You did put a dissected mass down me bra.
But there was enough room.
Hi, Mum. Hi, Auntie Shell. Oh, do I sense some bad vibes here?
Don't talk all druggy in my ass.
What?
You heard.
What's going down, Auntie Shell?
You will be if you don't mend your ways. Right, I'm going to ask you a question. I want you to tell me the truth.
I always tell the truth.
Oh, yeah. Like you don't take drugs.
I don't take drugs.
No, but you sell them.
What? I've been down your jacket and I found 50 quid. Now, that's got to come from somewhere.
You got no right to do that.
Don't talk to me about rights. They'll be reading you your rights if you don't mend your ways. Now, Dorian saw you come out of the frog's house last night and she saw him give you something.
She's jealous because she wanted him to give her something.
I want an explanation, Garth.
What is all this?
Do you deny that the garlic muncher gave you money?
Of course not. I earned it.
Ain't you got no shame?
About what?
About pushing dope.
What? Is that what you think? It's great to know your mum trusts you, innit?
So how did you get the money?
The garlic muncher is, in fact, none other than Emile Barreau. They mean anything to you?
No, I don't watch Crime Watch France, say.
Emile Barreau is one of the top chefs in the world, and he's recently moved to England to open a country house hotel. He also cooks for private functions, VIPs. With me so far?
Not a lot, no.
Well, I saw him at the French bakery last week.
Must be where Dorian got a carrot baguette.
And I recognised him from his celebrated cookbook. So I plucked up my courage and asked him if I could watch him in his kitchen. He said, no one watches him in his kitchen, but if I was any good with a paring knife, he'd let me dice some carrots for a private dinner party. And that's where the 50 quid come from.
50 quid for chopping carrots? I must be in the wrong game.
I'm really sorry, Garth.
You see, Mum, most things have a simple explanation. If only you ask. Right, I'm going out now to get well and truly oiled with my mates, who trust me.
I made a right balls up of that, didn't I?
Yep. Have you ever thought of writing a book on how to handle wayward youth? Mind you, come to think of it, it's more Dorian's line, isn't it?
Look, it ain't easy doing it on your own. You could lend me some support sometimes.
And risk another right-hander.
And what was Dorian going on about well-oiled Ukrainians for?
Promise not to hit me.
No promises.
Well, she saw them upstairs, so I didn't want to tell you it was the old Bill, so I just said the first thing that came into my head.
Which was?
That you had a sex puppet stashed in the attic.
You're sick, you are.
Well, she believed me.
What does that prove? We know she's sick. Come to think of it, none of this aggro with Garthy would have happened if you hadn't persuaded me to let Dempsey and Makepeace into my ass. Well, I've had enough. You can go up there now and tell them both to sling their hook. Go on.
I can't, Trace. Can't tell the police to sling their hook. I'll get it. It's Colin.
Oh, no, you haven't had burglars, have you? Not with two coppers on the premises.
Yeah, well, they won't be here for much longer, cos Sharon's just on her way up to tell them to sling their hook.
Well, I can't, Trace. Can't you tell them, Cole?
What? How can I? He's a DI. Look, I'm sorry, Trace. I mean, talk about bad career move.
Right. I will. They're in there, only they said not to disturb them under any circumstances.
They're not doing anyone any harm, are they, Tracy?
You can't just barge in, Trace. They could be in the middle of a really delicate operation.
Excuse me. Sorry to disturb you, but it's Mrs. Stubbs. Only we found out he ain't the French Connection. So I expect you'll be wanting to get back to the station there.
Go away. I'm onto something big here.
Go away? This is my ass.
Oh! Playing? Hide the truncheon? So that little scrubber weren't even a policewoman?
Nah. And it seems Dunford's been having a bit on the side with her for about 3 months now. She works in John Lewis. Lives in Gants Hill with her mum.
And he's married with kids, a dirty sod.
The thing I don't understand is why do it in my bed? When you can book into a sleazy hotel like normal people do.
Well, that's obvious, isn't it? They'd have to pay for an hotel. They conned me into letting them stay here for nothing, and I had to make them all that vegan food.
It's his wife I feel sorry for.
What? That's rich coming from the woman that's tested more beds than Slumberland's quality control department.
Anyway, Dunford knew Tracy could never say no to his little request. So when Sharon gave me the nod, Dunford took a week's paid leave, told his missus he was on a course in Huddersfield.
Why Huddersfield?
Does it matter?
Of course it matters. She's never used a course in Huddersfield before, have you?
And then he dresses his girlfriend in a hired police uniform and the rest is history.
It's a brilliant ruse, provided, of course, the sheets aren't brushed nylon. But what I don't understand is, if they spent all their time in flagrante delicto...
What's that meaning?
Giving her one.
Why did they bring all that expensive video equipment along?
Good point, though.
God, I hope it's not Betamax.